It was this patient's third creative arts therapy group session. In all of the sessions, he did not participate. He just watched us engage together in drama and movement improvisational explorations, including compositional explorations, where the teens created original short dramatic monologues and dialogues based on their day-to-day life struggles with mental health disorders. Near the end of this third session, the patient's unsettling dramatizations led to discussions surrounding their experiences with sleep paralysis, nightmares, and weird and strange dreams. I acknowledge their thoughts, fears, and unnerving experiences, enhancing our group discussion, or to be exact, matched the patient's own described imagery with the imagery portrayed in the disjointed prose found in William Burroughs' book on his own dreams, My Education, A Book of Dreams, and the artistic imagery portrayed in the aggressively unnatural Dream Logic horror fantasy films by director Dario Argento. Suddenly, without warning, the quiet teen stood up, looked at me and said, "I want to see these movies by this Italian guy now." Hello, this is Enrico, licensed creative arts therapist, New York State. The patient mentioned in this video approached me after our third group therapy session together and asked if I would meet with him for individual therapy sessions because he wanted to see some scenes from Argento's movies to see, as the patient put it, if it will help me understand and make connections to my nightmares and sleep paralysis. I said, of course. In our first therapy session together, the patient was somewhat reserved, anxious, but was cordial and engageable. I informed him that making a connection would be our goal for the therapy session, connecting together as a therapist and patient, and especially any connections made by the patient in any scenes in Argento's films. As a warm-up exploration, I asked the patient to draw using slow rhythmic repetitions for him to explore any types of felt sense and to find expression for any internal feeling states. I joined him in the warm-up, during which he informed me that he was not participating much in other group and individual therapy sessions, abruptly adding that he was plagued by nightmares and sleep paralysis due to past physical and mental abuse at home and at school. He reported that during his episodes of sleep paralysis, he could not move and was reflectively conscious while continuing to experience dreamlike sensations, such as intense and penetrating fears of being chased, visual and auditory nightmares, and different frightening figures near and around the bed, such as skeletons and shadowy figures. Again, contributing these nightmares to his past trauma. Then, abruptly, he said, "Can I see something from this director?" I said, "What do you think you are looking for if you see a scene from Argento's films?" He said, "I'm not sure, but I want to use it for an emotional release and to find something out about myself, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure why I am so interested in seeing this stuff." With that, I said, "Let's use Argento's films as a platform for discovery," to which he slightly smiled. A word of caution for clinicians. I only showed dreamlike scenes from Argento's movies to the patient to help stimulate the patient's thoughts, emotions, and feeling states, and did not show any of Argento's violent scenes due to the patient's horrific trauma history. Although Argento's violent scenes are a major part of his unique artistic journey in filmmaking, I would caution clinicians not to show these scenes to traumatized patients. The patient and I only had three individual therapy sessions together due to being discharged from the acute psychiatric unit. However, the multimodal creative arts intervention that naturally developed was unique to the patient and something I would not have considered if it were not for him and his interest in seeing scenes from Argento's films. The intervention consisted of us watching an Argento scene together, the patient responding by creating a collage using dreamlike images from various magazines, and, as requested by the patient, a closing ceremony of us destroying, as he put it, the negative collage together. To complete the ceremony, I offered to bury his negative collage after the therapy session in the dirt outside in the park. He He was excited about that. Interestingly, for me, the three individual therapy sessions that I had with the patient mentioned in this video were as beautifully disjointed, nervous, and dreamlike as Argento's films. I just went with it and watched the patient unfold as much as he wanted to unfold in the moment. Connections were made. I could see the patient silently making connections to Argento's imagery, not verbally processing it, but via collage making. The patient's collages are now gone, but his presence remains with me. Like an Argento film, it haunts me in a beautifully disturbing way.